When counting protons, neutrons, and electrons, this number listed above the symbol on the periodic table is called the atomic number, and it is the number of protons. As I look at the symbol, for example, let's look at sodium. If I'm given the symbol for sodium and a number is written in the upper left-hand corner, for example 25, that is the mass number. So the mass number for sodium written in this fashion is 25. And from that I can get the number of neutrons in that particular isotope of sodium. Now, not all atoms of sodium look like this. Some atoms of sodium might look like this with a different mass number. The mass number would be 24 here. Some isotopes of sodium might look like this. Some isotopes of sodium might look like this. If we look up isotopes on the internet, what we notice is that typically the stable isotopes of an element all fall within a very narrow range. You don't have to memorize those or anything like that. You just have to be aware that they exist. And so we see a variety of isotopes for sodium, and if we are given the symbol, we know which isotope we're looking at because that number is written in the upper left-hand corner. Each of these has a different number of neutrons. They all have exactly the same number of protons. They all have 11 protons, but they have different numbers of neutrons. Now, something else that they have different is their mass. We can talk about the mass, not the mass number, but the mass of this atom. This particular atom of sodium that has a mass number of 25, so it has 11 protons, because its atomic number is 11, 11 protons. 11 plus what equals 25? It would have 14 neutrons. The mass, how much it weighs, is very, 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 very light. The protons and neutrons each bring in about the same mass. The electrons, there would be 11 electrons around here, are all incredibly light compared to the protons and neutrons. So we could approximate the mass of this particular isotope of sodium just by considering the 25 protons and neutrons that make it up, because they're the heaviest part. So the mass of this particular isotope of sodium is very, very close to 25 atomic mass units. The atomic mass unit, the AMU, is a unit that was created to deal with the very light masses of atoms. The mass of this particular isotope of sodium will be different than the mass of this isotope because there's a different number of neutrons. The mass of this particular isotope of sodium will be very close to 24 AMU, and so on. This one will be very close to 23, it won't be exactly, and this will be very close, approximately 22 AMU. If I go out to the planet and I find me a pile of sodium and I dig up that sodium that occurs naturally, and I get my super duper powerful microscope, which doesn't exist, and I identify the isotopes in that sample, I would notice a distribution of those isotopes that occurs naturally, and there wouldn't be equal numbers of each of the naturally occurring isotopes. Some isotopes have a bigger abundance than others, and this is not something that you necessarily have to memorize, you just have to be aware that it exists. If I take a weighted average of all the different isotopes, all the different isotopes of sodium that occur naturally, I would get a mass of the average atom of sodium to be 22.99 AMU. Very close to the 23 that I see in this one, but not exactly the same. The weighted average takes into account all the different isotopes of sodium that occur naturally and their abundances. This is kind of like your GPA. Your GPA is a weighted average. If you make mostly A's but a few B's, your GPA will be very close to 4, but it won't be exactly 4.0, because exactly 4.0 would be all A's. If you make mostly C's but maybe a few B's or a few D's, your GPA is going to be very close to 2. Not necessarily exactly 2, but close to 2, because it's a weighted average. All right, so as I look at the isotopes that occur in natural abundance, There are tables of these values if I want to bother to look them up. But the weighted average of all the naturally occurring isotopes, the weighted average mass, is written on the periodic table. They've already done it for us. If I look at this number listed below the symbol, this is the weighted average of all the naturally occurring isotopes, taking into account their abundances. And in this particular periodic table, everything's rounded to the second decimal place. So the weighted average of all of the naturally occurring isotopes of chlorine is 35.45 AMU. We call this the atomic mass of chlorine. We do not call it the mass number. We call it the atomic mass. The mass number is different from the atomic mass. So on a test question or a homework question, if it asks for the mass number, you're looking at that number in the upper left-hand corner. If it asks for the atomic mass, you're looking at that number written below the symbol on the periodic table. Not very different things, but they are different things. So the atomic mass of an atom of nickel would be 58.69 AMUs. The atomic mass of an atom of potassium would be 39.10 AMUs. You can find these atomic masses with more decimal places in other tables. This table is just all rounded to the second decimal place.